Hi, I'm Rhonda Friend. I'm your health and human science educator and 4-H educator here in Fayette County, and this is the Extension Kitchen. Today I have my sidekick, my twin. We were just talking about we got short hair, we both have glasses, we both have an obnoxious laugh, so there's
and
that.
And the green shirts.
And we both got green shirts on, and so we share the 4-H program responsibilities here in Fayette County with a ton of wonderful volunteers. So today we're going to talk about 4-H, and so you're going to make caramels, and I'm going to show you how to make 3-2-1 magic, and why did we choose those things?
So we chose the caramels because microwave foods is one of the 4-H projects that we have. And this is actually the recipe from the 4-H member who won Grand Champion at the fair in 2020. So I'm really excited that she shared it with us, and we're going to make it.
So is that one of the projects that can go to state fair? So she won at state fair with this recipe?
No, she won at county fair with this recipe.
Okay.
Yes. Yep.
So how special is that?
That's right. I'm excited that she shared it. So
I'm hoping today that we can tell you a little bit about 4-H and about how many projects do we have?
We've got quite a few. I would say maybe around 40 or so.
Or more if you break them all down. And we're going to tell you about a couple spark clubs that we started this year.
Right.
Every time I say that, I say spark plug. But they are spark clubs, so we'll get to that. But we're going to start with caramels.
That's
so
right.
Can you do your thing? So
you
tell them what you've measured out, and then kind of talk about how did you get to 4-H? And you were a 4-H'er as a kid, too.
I was a 4-H member. So I was a 10-year 4-H member here in Fayette County, and then I was a 4-H leader for 5 years in Fayette County, and now I'm in the Extension office. So it's been a pretty fun progression as I continue to learn and understand what all it takes to put a 4-H program together. It's a lot of work, and it takes a good 11, 12 months out of the year, right, Rhonda? It's we don't work just in June and July, so it's a lot of prep work.
And
we have lots of volunteers, lots of organizations and groups that help us. This is not something Rhonda or I could ever do by ourselves. So we're very grateful for so many of you in the community that help us out.
Yes, and always looking for new volunteers.
That's right.
So last year, so we're in our second year, so we'll hit...
That's right.
Two complete years, September 3rd. We hired in on the same day.
We did.
And I remember, we cleaned, we sorted, because we're still trying to figure out what we do.
That's right.
And then, December hit, and we're like, wow, so this is like the downtime until this past December.
Yeah.
And then we realized that once you learn the job, there is never
a
day off.
No.
So lots and lots of stuff to do to keep 4-H program. And there's a lot of reasons to keep 4-H in our county, I think.
Yeah, absolutely.
So why don't you go ahead and tell them, it looks like you've already measured all that.
Yes, I've pre-measured everything.
And it's microwavable.
Yes, this is microwavable. So the most important thing to start with is a microwavable dish. Don't use Tupperware, don't use Rubbermaid, don't use metal, glass, dish.
Don't use metal in the microwave.
So about this size really is what you need, because as you continue to microwave this product, it's going to bubble and grow a little bit. So I would not recommend anything smaller than this, because it almost went over on me this morning when I made a batch. So we're going to start with our first ingredient. We're going to do 1/4 cup of unsalted butter.
Real butter, not margarine, not a spread, butter.
And it's unsalted, so that's the most important thing to remember.
Okay.
Now, the difference between salted butter and unsalted, clearly, is that there's a difference in salt. But the unsalted butter gives us a more creamy texture and flavor, which is really important when you want to do caramels. All right, so in here we've got 1 cup of brown sugar. Now, as you notice, this is light brown sugar. There's also dark brown sugar. So the difference is the amount of molasses that's in the brown sugar.
Yeah.
And so depending on what flavor you like, a more potent flavor or not, so I just use the light brown sugar, but you can also use the dark. So we've got the 1 cup of brown sugar. I also put 1/4 teaspoon of salt in here already. So those two are combined. We're gonna put that in our little dish. Okay, now the next thing we need is 1/4 cup, goodness, a half a cup of corn syrup. Now, you can use the generic, you can use Karo syrup, whatever you want. Uh-huh. It does not matter. A half a cup of the corn syrup. So we're gonna
add
that.
Now I'm going to say, you use corn syrup when you make pecan pie.
Yes.
And I have noticed the difference, I'm just saying, between Karo syrup and a generic.
There you go. That's right.
So I think it can there's be different. More product consistency if you use
Karo syrup.
Are we allowed to talk about brands?
I don't know.
I'm just saying, it works better.
We just
better.
Won't do it.
It works better than some generic.
The final thing is a half a cup of sweetened condensed milk. So for this recipe, the good news is there's almost a cup in a can of sweetened condensed milk. So if you want to double the recipe, you
one can do
that.
One can will do it. And that is not evaporated milk.
That's
is
correct.
A can
it's the sweetened condensed
milk.
Yes,
okay.
A good question. That's very important because those can be mixed up. Oh, isn't it? Yes.
Now, so we're not going to talk necessarily about nutrition, about this.
Yeah.
This is a sometimes food.
There you
this
go. It's
is,
a special treat.
You're not going to eat a half a plate.
No.
Well, we have.
Yeah. You shouldn't. That's the key,
shouldn't.
Right?
She'll bring like a whole pan of brownies, and then we eat a half a plate of brownies, you know, with our little token salad so we don't have to guilt her.
I know. The last time I made these caramels was Christmas, and I made them as gifts for people. So maybe think of them as special occasions like that.
Special occasions, a gift.
Yes.
You know, maybe a wedding or whatever.
I don't know what this
is. They're nice. So I've never made caramels, so I'm learning.
Yes, and this is a great, easy recipe, as you saw, with very few ingredients. We're done with the ingredients. So now what we're going to do, we're going to mix it up. You saw me mix it up just a little bit here. We're going to put it in the microwave, and we're going to put it in for 1 minute. Okay. Now, for our purposes of today, we're just going to do a sample. What you want to do is 1 minute, take it out, stir it, go a minute again. You want a total of 6 to 7 minutes in the microwave. You'll see as you stir with the fork, you'll feel that the brown sugar is dissolving and it's really becoming a smooth and consistent product.
So 6, 7 minutes.
Yep, 6, 7 minutes.
Is there a point
between.
That it's too far? Like, can you over?
You can, and I've never got there.
Okay.
Especially with corn syrup, that can really bind things together and cause a rock solid product. So don't do more than 7 minutes for sure. you'll be disappointed for sure because you want these caramels.
So if somebody signed up for 4-H, and how much does that cost this year to sign up?
So this year it is free. So we had some donors this year that came forward, which we're very grateful for. And those donors paid for our county fees, county and state fees actually. Okay, so we're going to bring this here. Now, one thing that you're going to want to do, it's not super hot right now, but as you continue, this bowl and is going to get very hot. So you're going to want some oven mitts. You're going to want a towel or a cooling rack as you continue to add your time. So we're going to stir this and mix this
up. And as the butter melts, you kind of let it incorporate better into your caramel mixture.
Exactly. We can do one more. How about we do one more minute so we can see. And you see, you know, it's not bubbled up yet. This is only our first minute. we're going to get this.
All right.
All right. We're going to go for one more minute.
So we sign up for 4-H.
Yes.
So our family signs
up. Sign up is online.
V2.4H.
Yep. Online.com.
Online.
Yep.
.org. Isn't it an
org? .com.
It's a .com.
Yep.
I was wrong. And then so that gets the family in. And
correct.
Then as they're filling out their information and it gets to the payment, what should they click since it's free and fair?
I believe it's, you know what, I'm not quite sure. We'll have to, our office manager, Stephanie.
Do not
Stephanie,
click credit card.
Yes, do not click credit card. It might be
click
check.
Click the other one.
That is on there. But we send our families information on how to do that. Or you can call our office, the extension office. We're located in the courthouse. Stephanie is
we're
our office manager. She's amazing.
She is amazing.
She could walk you through all the steps.
She could tell you about all the projects.
Yes.
So if somebody wanted to do microwave cooking, can they pick their recipe?
Absolutely. So for each project, there are we have a manual that gives you the rules for each division, depending on your grade. Mini 4-H is kindergarten through second grade. Regular traditional 4-H, thank you, is third through 12th grade. So for each age, there is specific rules and regulations for each project, not just for microwave foods, but for everything, so that as you become older and more experienced in the project, you gain more knowledge that makes you need to do more complicated things to show that you have learned.
Fantastic.
So you see here, we're stirring this up. You can see that the butter is now melted. It's still a little gritty, so we know we've got still some brown sugar that needs to go. So we've done 2 minutes. And again, as I mentioned, we want to do 6 to 7 minutes, but we won't do that whole thing. Now, at the last, once you hit 5 minutes total, that's when this starts really bubbling up and getting up around the edges. And it's very hot, as I mentioned before. So please be careful if you're doing this with children. Please make sure to use safety precautions, because you will get burned. I actually burned my pinky this morning because I thought I was going to be a hero and not use oven mitts, and it was a bad idea. So don't do that.
Real bad idea.
Real bad idea.
All right, so okay. If you set this aside, can you finish it later, or is it kind of wonky now?
So once you get it done with your 6 to 7 minutes, then you're going to take a pan. We're going to switch these two here. Pan about this size, 8x8, 9x9, something like that. And you're going to want to put some cooking spray on there or some butter so that it doesn't stick.
Okay.
Then you're going to pour this into your pan, and you see how beautiful it looks, I think. And you need to let that cool completely. So this I made this morning, and it's been sitting and cooling for about 4 hours. It's perfectly cool. It probably didn't even need the 4 hours, but it's looking great. So once it sits and it cools, now it's the fun part.
Yeah.
Now we get to eat it.
How do you get it out of the pan?
All right. So you're going to take a knife, a pizza cutter also. I've used a pizza cutter in the past. And you're just going to cut lines in strips as big or as small as you want.
Yeah, there you go.
So this is my caramel. This is yours.
This is mine. Thanks. Thank you, Heather. That's fantastic.
Oh, so we're going to cut into some pretty decent sized squares here.
Right.
It's very easy to cut. It's not a problem. Since we've used the cooking spray on the bottom, it comes out pretty easily. All right, once we got this cut, you're going to want to have wax paper. I've just taken a strip of wax paper, of course, cut them into small little pieces. And then I've got a little spatula here, a little metal spatula. And we're going to just scoop this right out. I probably need my knife to help me out here. Look how gooey and delicious this is. Oh, my. Woo, that's really gooey, actually. So we're going to put it on our wax paper. Mine, I like to kind of fold in half. Then it gives it a good kind of caramel look. Then you're going to wrap this up. Twist your ends. And now you are ready for a gift. This is what I did, little bags of caramels for Christmas gifts for people. It's very simple. It's few ingredients, as you saw. It's not hard to make. And again, Grand Champion recipe.
So if they want the Grand Champion recipe, if they emailed us or called the office, will we give it to them?
You know what? I will ask the person if I can continue the recipe on.
So, okay.
Yes, if you want it, call us and we'll find out for you. So, all right. There's our homemade caramels. We'll be digging into this in a little bit.
Yeah, I cannot wait to try that. Actually, that looks really, really good. So I'm going to go ahead and move on. So I'm going to show you how to do 3-2-1 magic. And again, this is a sometime food. This is when you don't want to bake a whole cake like you do.
Oh, I love cake.
Like a whole pan of brownies. And there's me, her, and Stephanie, because the nutrition education program people, they're out working all the time. And so they're rarely in there to help us eat it. She'll come toting in 24 cupcakes. And so this is,
this is a much better option. So if you live alone, if you have a kid quick snack or something, this is a good option.
Yeah, so all you do, you need an angel food cake mix. Now it's imperative you use an angel food cake mix. this is where, like, I'm going to be going, how do I get this bag of, I have no hand strength. Like, it's just awful. All right, so I meant
there
to bring
go.
Scissors soon, so.
Just don't cut your hand. We're
yeah,
good.
Just
We're
don't
good.
Cut it. So you're just going to dump that in here.
Now, why is it, you said it's imperative that one of these is an angel food cake.
Yes,
so explain
so angel
that.
Food cake mix has dehydrated egg white. So you don't add egg to this.
Okay.
So we're
going to
make.
Well, use a well ventilated area.
Oh, it's already open. It's already open.
How did
we
get open? All right. So we're just going to. I have, you know, so my I am not a chef. There are a lot of people are going, no kidding, Rhonda. Yeah. But I do like to cook, and I do love working with kids. That's
yeah.
the truth. Not just in 4-H, but we get out and do stuff in the community as
yeah.
well, don't we?
Yep, that's
you know
right.
where the trash went.
I've got
there
it, yep.
Go. Look at
Absolutely.
All this mess. So go ahead, tell them what you've been up to. I'm just, all I'm doing, so any flavor cake mix. So
there you
can
go.
Use vanilla, yeah. orange, strawberry, but the second box has to be angel food.
Okay, so
and
a regular just, food, a regular cake mix and angel food cake mix.
Yeah. So I'm just going to mix this up.
I love
right.
this.
Yeah.
And
so
really, several of the projects that we have involve cooking. So there's microwave cooking, there's foods, mm-hmm. there's food preservation.
Mm-hmm. Kids make bread.
There's freezer mm-hmm. Products that they learn how to freeze. These are not just skills to win a blue ribbon or a grand champion. These are life skills that kids need mm-hmm. To learn how to cook and mm-hmm. just the basics of measurements and mixing. A lot of times, mm-hmm. Kids aren't sure even how to use a measuring cup. So cooking with your kids is super important.
Yeah, and what's super nice about this, so again, now we've already mixed this, so it makes you feel kind of like you're committed to it, but all you do is you put it in a Ziploc bag.
Excellent.
And throw it in the cupboard with your flour. So I'm just
it's ready.
So like we can,
there
yeah,
you
this
go.
Is pretty ready. Just going to put it in a Ziploc bag. It's airtight. It'll keep for however long the cake mixes would have kept by themselves. So that's kind of that. You zip it up, throw it in your cabinet, and you're ready to go.
Ready.
Now, so we have lots of food projects. What are
yep.
some other things? Like, okay, so when
yeah.
I... Before I joined Extension again, we're in our second year.
That's right.
Our big two-year anniversary coming up September 3rd. I went to the Equity and Health Summit out at Chevy Chase, Maryland. I didn't even
that's
know there
right.
was such a thing at the National 4-H Center.
Yeah, that's right.
As a volunteer. So
yeah.
I got to do that and went with wonderful, beautiful Sarah Marvel. And we went out there and presented Second Street Park that we kind of
yeah.
envisioned. And at the time, we're like, can we get people to buy into that being the people's park? And we wanted it all 100% wheelchair accessible, and we envisioned
right.
even grandparents being able to go and play with their grandchildren. Because
yeah.
think about it, if you are have some impaired mobility, that's a challenge, you
that's
know,
right.
to play with your grandkids.
Mm-hmm.
So we went out there and we learned lots of things about health equity and stuff. But on the plane, so I get out, so Purdue flew us first class. We had a $600 limit. So, of course, I boarded last, middle seat, headed out there, middle seat, headed back.
There you go.
But I was happy to go. And I sat between two guys, one guy who pulled the hood up over his head and slept the whole way.
Yep.
Perfectly fine.
That's me.
That would have been.
Yep. I like to sleep on a plane.
But this guy was headed to D.C. I remember him. He was doing like some first responder training.
Yeah.
So he says to me, What are you doing? Where are you headed at? And I said, oh, I'm going to, and I didn't even know what it was, but I'm like, I'm going to the National 4-H Center in Chevy Chase, Maryland.
Yeah.
And he said, so 4-H, he says, like sheep. You know, so it's about sheep. Well, yes, it's about
yes.
sheep, cows,
foods.
Pigs, chickens, rabbits,
yeah.
goats, and goats. That was a big project last year, one that like 134 goat entries or something. So, but I was able to tell him that 4-H isn't just about showing animals, although that's a big deal.
It is.
It's about all this other stuff and learning life skills.
Absolutely.
I was able to take our junior leaders to the Leadership Summit. So it's about developing youth as leaders so that when we get ready to retire, that somebody will take
our place. That's right. Yeah, because I think a lot of people see 4-H and they see the 2 weeks of the fair, where they see exhibits such as the foods, the sewing, the posters, different things
the
like that, and the livestock, of course.
That's right, that the minis make.
But 4-H provides so many opportunities. There's many opportunities, as you say, to travel, leadership skills. We have 4-H camp every summer.
We're training
camp counselors
right now.
We have a mini 4-H camp. That's right. There's plenty of leadership opportunities. Right now, there's a photography contest that's going on, so we posted that information on our social media pages, and I know we've got one kid from Fayette County who's entered that. So there's opportunities to do bigger things than just the 2 weeks of the fair that often people see.
Mm-hmm. It's a lot of fun.
It is a lot of fun. They have great plans.
Yeah, and we've been training camp counselors, and so we have one Fayette County kid that's stepped up and wanted to be a camp counselor.
You have to be a high schooler to be a camp counselor, so we're really excited to get one
in. So that's a couple days of our life in June. We'll be gone playing with kids at 4-H camp. I am worried, like, if we do the canoe trip, who's getting me back in the canoe if we flip that thing?
I'm watching from the bank.
Are you?
No, this girl doesn't do water. No.
No, okay.
Mm-mm. I'll be cheering you on.
I might be with was like, can I bail out of the canoe? But just because I usually take a group of people who are like, we got you, we'll pull you back in.
No,
so
I'm not doing it.
Lots of stuff in 4-H. Beautiful
things.
And we have, tell them a little bit about 4-H Council and support group and what that group does.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go ahead and make this.
Okay. Yep.
Three.
There you go.
Are you ready?
Ready.
So three means three of your combined cake mix.
There you go, 3 tablespoons.
2. People are like, what is she going to do? 3.
There's 3.
And then we're going to do, have you ever done this?
I have done a version of this, a little bit different measurements that I've done. But
2.
I've made definitely
tablespoons of water.
Yeah. I've made the cake in the cup.
Yeah. So, and of course, I don't have a spoon out here. I hope
here,
this will
use this?
Yeah, let's do that. Okay. So, we are
professional folks.
So you just
don't try this at home.
We've got to
use a
spoon. Let's talk to John and make sure the commissioners don't get to watch this. Like they're gonna be like, what are those girls doing? But go ahead and tell them about our
We've got a lot of volunteers.
And we got
a
advisory.
Lot of people. Yeah, we've got a lot of people that help in the job. There's no way that Rhonda or I, Stephanie, could ever do the 4-H program without volunteers. So there's a 4-H council. That is a group that helps advise us on the programs, the fair itself that we're going to do, just kind of helps give us ideas and plans. There are a lot of the work behind the scenes that do. They do fundraisers. And really, we give them the rules that are required. There, as in everything in life, there are requirements, there are rules. And then from there, we give them that information, and then they're able to be creative and help our help our county have a successful and fun program for our kids. We've got the fair board helps us out quite a bit. We've got 4-H volunteers in the sense of there are several clubs in our county. I think we've got about 8 to 10 now. And each child that's enrolled in 4-H is a member of a club. That leader kind of instructs them and helps them on paperwork or different requirements of different projects, really is another guiding force in that child's life to have positive youth development as they grow up. So it takes a lot of volunteers, a lot of hours, a lot of sweat, blood, and tears, literally. You know, we're here for the kids of our community, for their growth and development. That's our number one goal in everything we do. We remind ourselves that often, that is our job.
Look at this.
Yeah, she's getting fancy over here with the strawberries.
I'm just cutting strawberries up for garnish, just to show how easy it is to make a microwave cake. So I'm going to go ahead and start this.
Yeah, I was going to say, we're missing the one. What's the one, Rhonda?
Plus 1 minute
there
in the microwave.
Yeah. Nice and easy.
So, isn't it, though?
Yes, I love it.
Okay, so I'm just going to cut one more. It looks like our mug cake is almost finished. So I want you to be super impressed. So I do want to say before we finish that 4-H has two new Spark Clubs this year.
That's right.
So we have Art Club, and we have four volunteers from the Whitewater Valley Art Association.
That's right.
We have about, and we're done. Look at this. Like, can you even believe it?
Oh, it's looking delicious.
Look at this. It made a cake.
Yay.
So we're going to offer projects. We've got in April, we've got stained glass.
Nice.
Mandala dot art. So,
ooh, yes,
and we're going to keep it to about 10 kids. Stained glass, I think, is 5 kids.
Okay. Is there a price for those classes?
Yeah, so they all come with a cost. So most of them are like $10. We're going to do the kind of Americana fiber fabric rug hooking.
Yeah.
And that's a $32 class, but thanks to the Fayette County Foundation, we have a little grant between Purdue Extension and the Art Association, so we're only charging $3.
Awesome. Again, sponsors, super important.
Crazy important.
Yeah.
So if there's some kids in our neighborhood here that wants to learn how to do this really folks arty kind of rug hooking, we're going to do acrylic pouring. We're going to do alcohol ink tiles. We've got just tons of stuff.
Yeah.
We've got some mini stuff.
That's going to
so
be
So even
fun.
The minis, and that's the kindergarten, the third graders can come, and we're going to do some Mother's Day cards.
So how do they reserve time or find more information?
So to sign up, all they got to do is call the office. And our amazing Stephanie.
Yes.
So that's 765-825-8502.
That's right.
Talk to Stephanie. She'll get you hooked up. Our other Spark Club is Keep History Alive.
Yeah, this one I'm really excited about.
So I'm super excited about that. So we have Sam Harvey, and we have Chris Friend, and Donna Schroeder, and they're going to have a history club and tell the youth in that club all about the history, the rich, beautiful history of Fayette County.
That's right.
And when the kids finish, their goal is, so the Historic Museum, their goal is to have ambassadors. So they're going to train kids to actually give tours. They're going to be taking care of the cars. They're going to learn all about the display. So when you pop in, these kids will be able to give
tours. That's going to be great. I think it's important to learn the history of your town and be proud of
that. Yes. And, you know, Donna, she and Chris both have a strong interest in genealogy.
Oh.
So there's a little connection there since we kind of have a project.
We do have a project called Genealogy.
Yes. Yeah, So look at this. Seriously, can you see that? That is just fabulous.
It looks amazing.
I know. So if I can get it, it's like, please, God, let it come out of the mug. All right. Please, God. All right. So I've got it broke loose.
There we go.
So look at this. So
super cute.
3, 2, 1.
Yes.
Super easy. Even a child can do this.
3 tablespoons.
Of the cake mix,
yep.
2 tablespoons of water, 1 minute in the microwave, and look,
done.
If you want to make it fancy.
A little more healthy than my typical full-on cake.
Well, no, you know what's
healthier? I'm going to be doing this in my house.
We don't have to eat the whole pan, so look at this. Look how pretty this is. So you just, and you could put, like, sugar-free pudding or Cool Whip on here.
Any kind of fruits, perfect.
Just make it fancy.
It's a good quick snack or a quick fancy little dessert for if you have guests over.
Right?
That's awesome.
All right. So I think our time is up. I've had fun.
Yeah,
we made
too,
a mess. Mom.
You know what? That's the best thing. Make a mess in the kitchen.
We get to eat some sugar. We got to talk
all in
about
moderation.
Beautiful. Yeah. So this definitely. So sometime foods.
There you go. That's right.
So even putting strawberries doesn't mean it's healthy. So
all right.
So sometime foods. So thank you for coming
You're
on.
You're welcome. Thanks for having
me. Look for us at the fair, out in the community. We're doing lots of good work here. Give us a call. We'd
That's
love
right.
to have you stop in and work on a project together. Till next time, take a step toward health, one meal at a time.